You went live on Facebook, congrats. But now, well, now you have to figure out, was it even worth it? How do you measure the performance of your live stream? Well, don't worry, because today we're moving beyond the surface level vanity metrics and taking a deep dive into Facebook Live analytics. What matters and what doesn't? Live video is awesome and super effective at growing your audience and creating a loyal following. But you have to understand if it's working for your goals specifically. So let's dig into making data-driven decisions to optimize your Facebook Live videos so that they can actually grow your business. And by the way, after we look at the data part, we're actually gonna get into the real juicy info, which metrics actually matter. I'm gonna tell you why most marketers are getting their data and measuring wrong. Okay, so first, you need to be super clear on where you can even get analytics inside the Facebook ecosystem. So on your personal profile, zero, zip, nada. You don't get any analytics. Now in groups, you get group specific analytics, like how many members you have, whether engagement is going up or down, popular days and times for activity in your group, and who your most active members are, which can be useful in its own right, but you won't get much data around retention or live video views or engagement. But on your business page, you're gonna get all the analytics you want and probably more than you want. So let's take a look. So once you're on your Facebook page, what you're going to do is go into Creator Studio. So what we've got here is the dashboard, and you can definitely look at the dashboard for some general insights. If you click Insights on the left-hand side, you're really going to get to start to dig into some more analytics and information. So the thing is, you've got general insights, and if you want specific insights about any particular video, you will be able to do that by going individually into each video by clicking through. But really what you're looking at right up front is the performance of your videos in general, of your whole page. So in the performance section, you have your minutes viewed, and then you can click through to see 1 minute video views and if it's up or down from a previous set timeline, which you can change right here. Go yesterday, last 28 days, this month, this quarter. You then are looking at 3 second video views. 3 second video views, now keep watching till the end because there's something we need to talk about when it comes to 3 second video views. Or you can look at engagement. This is a super helpful one because you're actually seeing higher engagement or lower engagement. Are people showing up? Are they not? And then of course you can see your net followers as well, whether that's going up or down. You have the ability to look at how things were sorted. So let's go to minutes viewed. You can look at organic versus posted or cross-posted or shared, the followers. And here you can see live or video. Now let's click on over to loyalty. Of course, loyalty is one of the most important things, in my opinion, in terms of your audience engagement, because that means that people are coming back over and over and over. They like your content. So you're looking at net followers, complete views. If you look down here, you can actually see, you know, how many returning viewers you had and which videos they return to. That will give you an idea of what kind of content you should actually keep creating. If they're not returning to a piece of content you thought they would, guess what? You need to make some adjustments. All right, now we're gonna click on the audience tab. And of course, this will give you a lot of information around your audience. Who are they? Where are they watching from? So while this isn't going to give you much information in terms of engagement, you can use this to say, all right, well, I have 114 engaged viewers in this period of time that we've chosen. My countries are high United States. They speak English, then you really wanna dig into, all right, they're men, 35 to 44 primarily for the engaged viewers. So start targeting content to the types of people who are watching you. So now let's click on retention, and this will give you a better understanding where your viewers are coming from. We're looking at recommendations. Is Facebook recommending your video after another video? Followers. This is a great one to look at because now you know, are my followers actually still interested in my content? You can look at if views are coming from your shares as well. Average time people spend watching. Now, this is a tricky one to actually garner some information from. I'll talk about that more in depth in a minute. How long people are watching, of course, this is really right in the same vein as what I was just talking about. But you can look at the retention graphs as an overview, but do not put too much pressure on yourself when it comes to these particular insights. So while your general insights are gonna give you a great look at how your page is doing with all content, we really wanna look at individual live videos to understand how your live videos are performing. So we're gonna click on the most recent live video and the peak live viewers. This is one of the most important pieces of analytics you need to be paying attention to, and whether that's increasing over time. Also, where is your peak happening? If your peak is happening right at towards the top of the stream, like this one is, it's happening at 4 minutes and 45 seconds. That's actually very unusual. Most people's peaks happen 18 to 20 minutes in your live video. So you can adjust content based on that information if that's happening consistently on your channel. All right, minutes viewed. This is a stat that you can look at over time. Is it gaining? Is it increasing? Now, because of the way Facebook tracks analytics, views, and the way the nature of Facebook is being a feed, it is actually pretty misleading a lot of the analytics that you're gonna see in these videos. So you can't look at any of them in isolation. Let me give you an example. We're looking at 1 minute video views, 10 seconds, 3 seconds. A lot of that is coming because the feed is scrolling by, and that's not going to give you an accurate description of what is actually happening. Especially if we click into average video watch time, you see that people are actually watching. However, the video average percent watched is citing 0%. Well, that can't be the case. So again, use your brain, look at everything together, and you'll get a more accurate description of what's actually happening on your channel. Now, audience retention. So this graph will give you an indication of how long you're keeping people there in general. And the longer you keep them there, the better off you are. So in this graph, people are dropping off dramatically right at the beginning of the stream. Why? Now is the perfect chance to ask yourself those questions. Why? Are you not holding their attention? Are you not engaging them right up front? They want to talk to you. Are you not talking back to them? What's happening in your content that you can make adjustments to make that graph more stable? Now, keep in mind that the audience retention graphs are going to see some drop-offs. Every retention graph I've ever seen on Facebook has a big drop off right in the beginning. So don't let that discourage you. It's very, very important that you focus more on the engagement factors, the comments, the reactions, the things that actually are done by people instead of using these confusing graphs to confuse you and your data-driven decisions even more. So let's look at those engagements, because Facebook will actually show you what these engagements are. So if you go into post engagements, you'll see that 62 people liked this, 13 people loved it. One person gave a sad face, probably because of something that was said, or they accidentally hit the sad face. Sometimes you do get angry faces, sad faces, and it's actually not intentional. So don't go crying. But you can also see the total number of comments, the total shares. So if shares is something that's really important to you to get more organic traffic, then ask for that in your streams and track how many shares you're getting. So when we look at Funnel Insights, this is actually Facebook attempting to be helpful with these 3 second and 10 second views and give you a little bit more of an understanding of how engaged your audience is. So basically it's taking the 3 second views, trimming that down to the 1 minute video views, and then looking at the engaged people. This is the number of people who commented, shared, or reacted to your video. So if you're looking for percentages, that's where you would find this. So while all of these insights are fantastic and you'll be able to understand more about how your live stream is performing, here's the biggest mistake that other marketers make that I don't want you to make. That mistake is making all of your decisions based on those insights alone. Analytics can be really powerful if interpreted correctly, and they can be equally as dangerous if you aren't looking at the right metrics. So avoid making super isolated decisions based on this information, because the truth is, Facebook insights can be pretty misleading. So you need to look at your data points as they relate to each other, not just alone. Do not pay attention to the 3 second or 10 second views. First of all, seeing that 80% of people watched for 3 seconds is super depressing. Secondly, it's actually misleading because there are a lot of factors of live video that are different than recorded video. For example, people come and go in a live broadcast a lot. Maybe they get a phone call and they were watching on their mobile device, so it interrupts the stream. They come back though. That's counted as a new session. So while they may have been there for 3 seconds the first time, got a call, came back and watched for 15 minutes, they're counted differently. So it's not accumulative. There are many reasons why people may come and go in a live broadcast. Do, however, pay attention to the ratio of engagement to viewers. You have 100 simultaneous viewers, and if you have 2 people commenting, not a good ratio. You absolutely want more people commenting and engaging than that. So if you can hit a 20 to 30% engagement rate, in other words, 20 to 30% of simultaneous viewers are actually leaving comments, you're doing good. Beyond that, and you can consider your streams to be highly engaging. Do not pay attention to minutes watched unless you're using it to compare your growth over time. Do, however, pay attention to unique viewers. That'll really give you a better understanding of how many people you're actually reaching. Here are 2 guiding principles to remember. 1, at the end of the day, your goal with live video should be to create loyal fans for your brand. I would rather see you have 50 viewers watching with a 75% engagement rate rather than 100 viewers watching with a 10% engagement rate. Facebook Analytics will not show you this, by the way, so you really got to use your brain on this one. But I'm a firm believer that this matters more to your growth than any of the insights Facebook will give you. And 2, I want you to compete against you. Look at where you start, not somebody else, and work to constantly improve your metrics. You're gonna see faster results this way, I promise you that, and you're gonna get more creative in the process. So now that you know what to look for, how do you go about improving your engagement ratio? Well, click here for the video about improving your engagement. And also, if you're just figuring out all of this other stuff, I have a playlist on my Live Streaming Pros channel right here to help walk you through those fundamentals.